Welcome to 3dmotive.com. My name is Ricardo Rambarran, and today I'm going to be showing you the specular map, but more importantly, how to hide other masks within the specular map when importing it into UDK. So to give you an example, this is the mesh that I will be working with. As you can see that it does have an alpha as well as an emissive in the background. And finally, you have your normal spec. I'll try to get it a little bit better there. You have your spec map, your diffuse, and normal. So let's hop into Photoshop now and take a look at the different masks as well as the different textures. So you have your basic diffuse, I have the spec map, I have the normal. I also have my alpha. Let me just show you that. I have the alpha for the grate, and I have the emissive for the blue light, and there is another part of the blue line that appears on a different mesh. So normally when you import all of this into UDK, what you tend to do is you tend to break down each of the individual parts, you export them as a targa or another file format, and you basically plug in your different elements into material, create your material, and then move forward from there. Now the difference with this method is that what it's going to do, first of all, it's going to help you save texture space, which is really important when you're working on a larger project, especially a game or something that has a lot of meshes with a lot of different textures. What you're trying to do is limit how much your computer processing is going to take a toll on all of that. So the first thing you want to do is you're going to start with your spec map here. And as you can see, I have all my layers set up such that the spec map, once saved out as a targa, is one file. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hit a quick command to collapse all the files but still keep all the layers, and it's Control, Alt, Shift, and the letter E. And you're going to see that all of my layers now collapsed into one file. And how we're going to work with this is we're going to go into the channels. And you can see there's different channels and they all represent the same thing. So right now, everything is using the RGB. What we're going to do is we're actually going to try to tuck away the alpha map into one of the channels and the emissive map into the second channel, or at least, yeah, exactly, the second channel. One channel will be the spec, one will be the alpha, and one will be the emissive. So really the easiest thing to do is you start with your alpha. I do Control A to select all, Control C to copy it, and then you want to make sure you click on the spec map. Once you click on the spec map, the one that's all collapsed, you hit channels, and then you get a choice of working on one of the three channels of the color, the red, green, and blue. So a little bit of theory here, quick, is that the blue channel is the one that tends to have the least amount of details. So what you want to do is you want to put anything in the blue channel that you don't need any amount of detail, or you're not looking for precision necessarily, it's just to give an effect. So in my case, I will save the blue channel for the emissive. I will click on the green channel, and what I'll do is I'll just hit Control V, and as you can see, my texture kind of changed, and my RGB is kind of weird now, but that's perfectly normal. If you take a look at the red channel, it's still my spec map, however, it is a spec map in grayscale. You will lose all color in your spec map, and I'll show you quickly how to fix that once we get into UDK. When you hit the green channel, you can see that there's an alpha. And finally, the blue channel is still a spec map. So now we repeat the same process with the emissive. So I'll just hide that spec. I'll click on my emissive. I'll do the same process. Control A to select all. Control C to copy. Go back into my spec. I'll just make sure I hide the right channel. You always want to make sure you're working on the right layer in your Photoshop. So here I'm going to plop in the emissive into the blue channel, doing the same thing. Control V while my blue channel is selected, and there it is. And again, it's in grayscale, so I lose all that blue color that I will need later. So right now we have the spec on the red channel, the alpha on the green, and the blue is holding the emissive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to export this file into my UDK as well as my diffuse and my normal. I'm going to upload all of that into the engine, and I'm going to bring it into my mesh, and I'm going to show you guys how to plug it in to get this effect. So we're back into UDK now, And what I did was I simply imported the diffuse, the normal map, and our spec with the three masks inside. I plugged the diffuse and the normal actually into the mesh, and you can see that there is actually no mask, and there's blue, but that's only because my diffuse has the blue in there to kind of help the emissive later on. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna plug in our specular, and we're gonna see how this all comes together. So if you remember, our red is our spec map, the actual spec for the metal. Wait for it to load. And yeah, there it is. You can see that there is some shine, and there's some of those details we put into the spec. The green channel was our mask, so I'll drop that into opacity. And it's still thinking about it. And there it is. So you can see that the alpha appears. And finally, the last thing is our emissive. So if we drop the blue channel into our emissive, we should have exactly what we're looking for. And, well, we sort of do. It does work. We can see that the emissive did take over, but now the other problem we run into is since we're working in just the channels, all the color information goes away because it's all in grayscale. So now one way we can work with this to ensure that we're getting the right color is to treat this emissive as it would be any other texture that you wanted to change the color with in UDK. So one of the easy things to do is to simply just multiply it by another color and see what the results yield. So let's go into here, let's go into math, and I want to multiply. I think I could even do an add, but we'll try multiply first. It should give us similar results. And I want a color or constant. Let's go with vertex color. Sorry about that, a minor technical difficulty. So as I was saying, the actual constant that you would want to pick is the constant 3 vectors. This allows you to have more control on the color of the multiplier. So we just put that into the multiply. And just for the sake of the example, I will pump up the blue channel to, let's go with 2. Let's see what kind of blue that gives us. And obviously this is where you get to play around and to see where which color you need and how the tones change. So just wait for the blue. So you can see here that already in the emissive channel, the blue is working. So once we plug that into the emissive, our emissive should no longer be white, but rather the color it's being multiplied with. And there we have it. So with those tips, you're actually able to play around with masks in spec. Also, if you were wondering if you could change the color of the actual spec map, you can too. You do not have to work in grayscale. You can do the same function here I did, where you multiply it by a color to help accentuate certain features of your spec. And this is a great way of saving some time and some resources in your engine, especially if you are working with a lot of textures and a lot of meshes. So I want to thank you again for watching 3dmotive.com for this quick tip, and stay tuned for more great tips.